Hi, and welcome to ECCB Connects. On this week's episode, we share with you excerpts of a feature address which the Governor of the Eastern Caribbean Central Bank, Timothy N.J. Antoine, delivered during the New Year celebration service of the Royal St. Christopher and the Nevis Police Force. The event was held under the theme, Engaging and Reassuring Communities by Improving Our Service. In his remarks, Governor Antoine challenged the members of the police force to adopt a growth mindset, become better listeners, and bloom wherever they were planted.
I want to address you as one public servant to another, because police officers are public servants. I am a public servant. That's what I've done for the last 26 years of my life in various capacities. And therefore, what I'm going to offer you are some suggestions, in fact, three suggestions, which I believe may be of utility to you as you contemplate this new year and this new decade. Because this new decade affords you new opportunities. And the question is, how shall you now live? And how shall you now proceed? And that is the context in which I want to offer you three suggestions. And suggestions being what they are, you may take them or you may leave them. But I hope some of us will be smart enough to seriously consider them. So my first suggestion is simply this. Adopt a growth mindset. Adopt a growth mindset. It is said it is not how good you are, it is how good you want to be. How good you want to be. You see, 2019 is now history. And 2020 is before us. And what lies before the force are opportunities. Yes, challenges, but opportunities. And whether or not you are able to take the force to new heights and to make this federation even safer will depend on whether or not you have a growth mindset. A growth mindset is a tendency to believe you can grow, you can learn, and you can get better. And that's important because in contrast, there are some people who have a fixed mindset. In their minds, they have what God has given them and they can do no better. That is who I am. That is how I stop. Or as you may say, so I be in local parlance. That mindset then creates a cap, a ceiling on your potential to grow and to achieve new heights in your profession. And depending on the situation, people sometimes move between fixed and growth. And some people, when they see a challenge, they simply cannot respond to it. So as the force seeks new heights in 2020, the mindset of the force will either propel it or prevent it from attaining even higher levels of success. A fixed mindset avoids challenges. Because every challenge is a problem. And some of us don't like problems. A growth mindset embraces challenges and sees them as opportunities. You see, there's a reframing that's going on there. You see it as opportunities. A fixed mindset gives up easily, gets easily discouraged. Whereas a growth mindset perseveres even in the face of obstacles. A fixed mindset sees efforts as futile. Same old, nothing can change. Nothing can change. Nothing will change. Whereas a growth mindset recognizes that the challenges is in fact a path, present a path to success. So you see the journey. You see the journey and you embrace the journey. A fixed mindset avoids and ignores criticism. A growth mindset learns from criticism. Criticisms will come. It's the nature of the business that we're in, public service. In fact, it's the nature of life. So expect criticism. When you are faced with criticism, here's what you may wish to do. And I will tell you, here's what I do. I have two buckets. Truth or trash. They're going to fall in one of these two. If it's truth, I accept it, hard as it may be. And I try to find the kernel of truth. Even though I may not like the messenger who is delivering that truth, I try to find the kernel of truth so that I could get better. So that I could improve. So that I could learn. But if it is trash, I dump it and I move on and I don't look back. Because I'm not going to spend my energy looking at negativity, slander, libel, falsehoods, fake news, all manner of things. Yes, I know you have to respond to some fake news to make sure everybody knows what's going on. But the truth is, don't find yourself so bogged down with these falsehoods and this trash, as I like to term it, that you lose focus from the main thing. Because I always say, you know, everybody has to know what their calling is in life. Some of us are called to build, and some of us apparently are called to break down, to destroy. So when you're doing that business of destruction, I have to make sure I'm in the business of construction. I am not going to be carried away or diverted or distracted by your shenanigans. You will do what you have to do, because ultimately, we're going to answer to our God. And I need to make sure when I answer to my God and he asks me, what did I do with my time on earth, I have something good and sensible to offer. So everybody has to decide, truth or trash. A fixed mindset feels threatened by others, the success of others. Whereas a growth mindset celebrates the success of others and learns from them. Not, I don't like how this person look or what happened to them or where they're going. Not that they're too young and they're moving too fast. But the growth mindset embraces and celebrates with others. You want to see people do well. You take joy in seeing a brother or sister do well. And maybe your turn hasn't come, but hold on, your turn will come. We hope. Rather than being all resentful and pitiful because you haven't given an opportunity. You have not been recognized. You have not yet had your great moment of success. And finally, with a fixed mindset, that person is stagnant and often enters a downward spiral of negativity, mediocrity, and even non-performance. You see, what happens in those instances is that they begin to exude negative vibes, negative energy. And you cannot grow with negative energy. You need positive energy. In fact, to do anything significant in life, you need energy. And you need positive energy. In contrast, the growth mindset is growing and enters an upward spiral of even higher levels of performance. So I want to challenge you, both as a force but as individuals as well, to adopt this year and going forward a growth mindset. That means, for example, you have to learn from your failings. Somebody in this force has to have somebody and somewhere a repository of all your learnings. And you need to see learnings, failures, not as failures, experiences, but as learnings. How do you get better? You know what happens very often with organizations? When there is no attempt to formally document their learnings, they keep repeating the same mistakes. And that demoralizes everybody. So adopt a growth attitude, a growth mindset, by putting your learnings together and making them available to all members of the force. The second suggestion is this. Become a better listener. Become a better listener. Become a better listener to your family, to your community, and to your God. Now, Listening is the least practice of the four communication skills. And yes, there are four communication skills. Do you remember what they are? So let's go through very quickly. There is writing, reading, speaking, and listening. Correct. More studies show that that 75% of the world's population does not listen well. Let's flip that. It means that only one in four persons is a good listener. So what is listening? My wife, of almost 23 years, March will be 23 years, a long time ago taught me what is listening. She said, listening is wanting to hear. Very simply. Listening is wanting to hear. You see, the purposes of listening are twofold. One, to connect with people, and two, to learn. And in community policing, which is key to detection of crime, you have to become even better listeners. You see, the challenge with listening is that most of us, as T.B. Covey says in his 7 Habits of Highly Effective People, Habit 5, most people do not listen with the intent to understand. They listen with the intent to reply. Let's think about that. In leadership, the comments will come. But recognize one thing. Feedback is a gift. Hello? Feedback is a gift. We may not always like the gift, but it is a gift. And so, very important, at any level of the force, at any level, high command or the entry level, you need to have a growth mindset when it comes to feedback. See it as a gift. And if you do, people will come to you and share things with you which will make you better because you want to learn, you want to grow, you want to get better. You know, at the ECCB, one of the things we have in our star mantra is something called, and it's a work in progress, truth telling. So the star mantra at the ECCB is S means service excellence, and we share that, we public servants. T stands for teamwork and truth telling. A stands for accountability, and R stands for results. That's our star mantra. And we added truth-telling about a year. So on the first day I arrived, I gave them the star mantra, first day in office. But then a year later, we added truth-telling as a second in the T. Well, it's one T, but the second. So teamwork and truth-telling. Because we wanted to encourage people to speak truth to power. We wanted to give people the permission to be open with their views while being respectful. And that's the difference. Because you can deliver truth, but if you deliver truth with no grace, that's a problem. As one person put it, right plus rude equals wrong. Some of us will say, that's who I am. So I stop. I tell them as I see it. I'm a straight shooter. Well, in corporate life, you have to know how to deliver the message. Deliver it truthfully, but with respect, with grace. And you're going to find that more often than not, as you do that, people will listen to you more. Because some of you get very frustrated when you have ideas or you have suggestions and you're not getting through. Well, I want to say to the person who is above you, your reporting officer, you need to understand feedback is a gift and allow and encourage that feedback. But I also want to say to you, who might be delivering the feedback, watch your tongue and watch your tone. Because very often, that is where it breaks down. That is where it breaks down. And at that point, they are not listening to you. It doesn't matter what you're saying and how good it is. They have made a decision that you're rude and out of place, you're out of order, and they're not taking you on. So you need to understand that and just recalibrate how you say what you say. You can still be truthful. You can still give the feedback. But the tone is important. The tone is important. Become a better listener. You will learn more. Your family will thank you for it. Your girlfriend will thank you for it. Your partner will thank you for it. And the force and the community will thank you for it. Adopt a growth mindset, become a better listener. And I have one more and I'm going to stop. And the third one is this. Bloom wherever you are planted. Bloom wherever you are planted. Assigned. Deployed. Now this is very important, especially for rank and file. Because the nature of policing is that you will move around from time to time. You have to gain experience and to gain exposure. And those of you who find yourself out in the outstation in the rural areas, that's a very important part of your development. And don't underestimate that vineyard, that period in the vineyard, what you might find is seemingly almost behind God's back. Don't underestimate that experience. It allows you to understand people, build your relationships and network with the community, and it is these same people who will turn around and have your back as you rise up the organization. If you made a good impression while you were serving in the outstations. Don't, as the scripture says, despise the day of small beginnings. Some of you want to reach in high command, but you have to go through to get through. Yes? I want to see people move up, but understand the journey. The growth mindset understands the journey and embraces the learnings. And when you get to a higher position, you bring not just, you know, experience, but you bring skills, you bring perspectives, and you bring a network of people who you can tap in this business of policing. Because the community relations are key to making an effective police and to have a great force. So that police officers ought to demonstrate professionalism at all times. And to that end, I invite you to recall one of my life verses. This verse has really guided me throughout my life. Colossians 3:23. Many of you know it. Whatever you do, work at it with all your heart, as working for the Lord, not for human masters. I cannot tell you how much I have relied on this verse as I have worked with different administrations over my time as a public servant. Many of you are people of faith, and you know of the story of Joseph in the Bible. Falsely accused, thrown into prison, ultimately rose to become the prime minister of Egypt. From the pit to the palace. So here is the question. What does Joseph Tillman Thomas, former prime minister of Grenada, and Nelson Mandela have in common? What do those three men have in common? They all had unwanted transfers. They all ended up in jail. Yes. Yes. They did. All had unwanted transfers. But you know what? They did not become bitter. They became better. They understood the power of forgiveness. And they understood what Corrie ten Boom, a Holocaust survivor, once said. Forgiveness is releasing a prisoner and then realizing the prisoner is me. Forgiveness is releasing a prisoner and then realizing the prisoner is me. Or as Archibald Hart put it, forgiveness is surrendering my right to hurt you for hurting me. Oh, I'm not sure who I'm speaking to this morning. But first and foremost, we are citizens, we are individuals. And these thoughts should guide us and help us in life, in living, and in serving in the Royal St. Christopher and Nevis Police Force. All three gentlemen rose to become either the prime minister or president of their country. But they had an unwanted transfer. They all were incarcerated and spent time in jail. Let me conclude by saying three suggestions. Some of you look very, very serious now. That's okay, because I want you to be thoughtful. I want to motivate you and encourage you, but it starts with a deep reflection and then a move to action. three suggestions. One, adopt a growth mindset. Two, become a better listener. And three, bloom wherever you are planted. I want to suggest to you, in fact, I know of which I speak. Were you to take these suggestions on board, the Royal St. Christopher and Nevis Police Force will scale even higher heights in 2020 and beyond. And you deliver the kind of service that the people of this federation desire and deserve. God bless you in your efforts. I stand with you. Thank you very much. God bless.
To view any episode of ECCB Connects anytime, any place at your convenience, check us out on YouTube, Facebook, and LinkedIn at ECCB Connects. We now present Did You Know?
Debt to GDP. Did you know that the Monetary Council of the Eastern Caribbean Central Bank set a debt to GDP target of 60% to be achieved by the year 2030? This goal is in keeping with the Sustainable Development Goals set by the United Nations to achieve a better and more sustainable future for all.
That's it for this week's episode of ECCB Connects. Be sure to stay connected with us on Facebook, YouTube, and LinkedIn as we share with you who we are, what we do, and how we serve you. Thanks for watching.